Dr. Pranjali Bisht, and today we will going to perform our volumetric analysis, and under this we will going to check or determine the strength of unknown ferrous ammonium sulfate solution by titrating it with the known potassium dichromate solution using external indicator. So the external indicator which we will going to use in this practical is potassium ferricyanide. So let me demonstrate you the principle of this practical first. In this practical, we need to check the strength of ferrous ammonium sulfate. For this, we will going to titrate the ferrous ammonium sulfate with or against the potassium dichromate solution. Since potassium dichromate is acidified here and it is an oxidizing agent, so it will going to release three nascent oxygen after the reaction. And these nascent oxygen will going to oxidize the ferrous ammonium sulfate into ferric ions. As a result of which, we will get the respective sulfates of all the metal ions present in the reaction mixture. To this reaction mixture, we will going to add the external indicator. So, at the end point, we will get the colorless solution. This indicates that all the ferrous ions are converted into ferric ion, and ferric ion will not form further complex with the indicator, as indicator also contain the ferric ions. So, let us start the practical. So for this, we are going to fill this burette with the potassium dichromate solution. So this is our potassium dichromate solution, and I will going to close this knob, and then we are going to keep this funnel and we are going to fill the burette. Since the reading exceeds the 0 ml, so I will going to pour out some of the solution to get exact 0 ml. So now this burette has the capacity of 50 ml, so I have filled till the 0 ml. Since the solution is colored, so I will going to see the upper meniscus of the solution. The upper meniscus should touch or should matches with the 0 ml line of the burette. So this is how we have filled the burette with the potassium dichromate solution. In the first practical, we will going to have the known ferrous ammonium sulfate. So this is our known ferrous ammonium sulfate. I will going to pipette out 25 ml of this solution with the help of pipette. This is 25 ml ferrous ammonium sulfate. So for now, this is the reaction mixture. I have taken the known ferrous ammonium sulfate to standardize the potassium dichromate first. After standardizing the potassium dichromate, then we are going to repeat the same practical for the unknown ferrous ammonium sulfate. So let's start. So we need to mix the potassium dichromate drop wise to the ferrous ammonium sulfate, and for every 1 ml, after adding every 1 ml of the solution, I will going to add the external indicator. So let us stop it and mix the reaction mixture. So here the dichromate will going to oxidize the ferrous of the ferrous ammonium sulfate into the ferric ions. So let's see and check the visibility of the ferric ions into the solution with the help of external indicator. So I will going to have this porcelain disc or the plate. This is the glass rod. Through this glass rod, I will going to have a drop of the reaction mixture into this porcelain disc. Again, I will going to wash it with the water, and then I will going to have a drop of an indicator, external indicator, that is potassium ferricyanide. As you can see, the blue color is present. It indicates that the ferrous ions are still present into the solution. So let us continue the titration. after addition of 1 ml again I will going to have the reaction mixture and will going to check the presence of ferrous ions. Every time you need to wash the glass rod with the help of water, and this is our indicator. Blue color indicates that the complex formation is taking place. We will get the colorless solution when no complex formation takes place. Again, I will going to add 1 ml or 2 ml, I guess. Let us check. Again, it is blue color solution. Let us add few more mLs, I guess. Complex formation is taking place. It means that the reaction mixture contains the complexes of sulfates of different metal ions. When all ferrous is converted into the ferric, then the complex formation will stop and we will get the colorless solution. So let us check whether we will get the colorless solution now. Yes, you can see here, you can see that initially we get the different colors, different shades of the blue. It means that in this at this point the ferrous is present inside the solution in the form of complex. This indicates that all the ferrous ions are converted into the ferric ion, and now no further complex formation will takes place. Why? Because this indicator also contain the ferric ions. So the here also we have a ferric ions, and in indicator also we have a ferric ion. So complex formation will stop, and this is the end point of this titration. So by doing so, what we have done, we have basically standardized the potassium diode. So this is the first step of this titration. Now we are going to calculate the strength of potassium dichromate. Now for second titration, this will be the standard solution, and we will going to take unknown ferrous ammonium sulfate in second case, and we will going to repeat the same practical. So this is how the practical takes place. Thank you.